futuristic R&B.
It's gonna get nasty. I want you at the tip of my tongue, all down your body. No, this is your pony. Ooh, and I want you to ride it, so I can drink your rivers down. You quench my thirst, babe. No.
I'ma hop out them bushes, I creep through your window like, fuck is you doing? I'm feeling like a stalker. Girl, you know I'm crazy, that pussy amazing. I'm driving your waters. Let me keep you till the morning.
Say you be popping your pussy, you tell me you honest. I know when I see friends with benefits. You know my Cartier friends got limousines. But I can see through the attitude and silly shit.
Girl, no, don't do that no more.
Not no more.
Took her out the car right on the hood. We was fucking like animals.
Ten Black Nation Codes of Conduct. 1. I am black first, before I am anything else, and all my alliance and total allegiances are as such, because I am black first. 2. I will not engage in display, support nor propagate anything that gives a negative reflection upon my black people, to include, but not limited to, news, entertainment, information, social media, etc. Because I am black first. 3. I will spend my money within my black community first, and only spend the minimal amount elsewhere until I am able to buy it in greater quantity from a black business owner. Because I am black first. 4. Everything I make for or sell to my people will only be my best, and I will conduct all business transactions with my people in a decent, honorable and orderly manner. Because I am black first. 5. I will not allow anyone to talk down upon, discredit, disenfranchise or discriminate against anyone black. Because I am black first. 6. I will educate myself, family, friends and associates about world history, which is black history. Because I am black first. 7. I will honor and align all my total allegiances with my black people. Meaning, any and all boycotts associated with black people is my business, and it warrants my full, complete and total cooperative support. Because I am black first. 8. I understand having black pride does not negate anything nor anyone else, but it will foster an increase of self-respect while uplifting all people to understand and respect my black people. Because I am black first. 9. I will handle any and all personal issues about or with my black people within my own black community first. Because we are black people first. 10. I will not allow media, law enforcement, politicians, political ties, friends, be it foreign or domestic or business associates nor etc., to speak about or concerning black issues without the support of an appropriate black official representative present. Because my black people are my first priority. Because I am unapologetically black first.
The Honorable Elijah Muhammad says when the scientists went out and sampled the thinking of the people, they saw that in the year 8,400 of this present cycle, a man would be born named Yaqub. Born with a determined idea to make a new people. On this earth, a new people that would be strange and different from any people that had ever been on this planet before. And that this people that he would make would rule with a contrary civilization that would wreak havoc on the earth. And when they brought their findings back to Allah, the judge, He looked at it. He could have said, we don't want this. He said, let it be. Why are you going to allow all this suffering? Because it's going to manifest human nature to its fullest, and it will test the people under evil to see whether evil is as productive in their lives as good, so that at the end of this experiment, each of them will know that evil is not the way that they should go, but you must choose righteousness. And the only way you will choose righteousness voluntarily is that you must suffer enough under evil. But the evil that you see in operation, ultimately you must come to know that it springs from yourself. And then not only will you call for the destruction of this evil world, but you will call for the destruction of the evil in yourself that this is the manifestation of. Then you are ready to be made whole, perfect. Yaqub was not wicked. Yaqub was born with a determined idea. Stop right there. Determined past participle. If he was born, he didn't determine the idea. So the man had nothing to do with it. So what the hell are you blaming Yaqub for? Somebody bigger than Yaqub had determined that he was the one to be born out of the dissatisfaction of the masses. 30% of them were dissatisfied, to bring about a change that would affect the entire earth. So a child was born genetically prepared to do a work that would shake the entire world. His name was Yaqub, a black man. And that young boy at 6 years old saw, as he was playing in the sand with two pieces of metal, he saw one attracting the other under its power. And he said, when I grow up, I'm going to make a people all alike who will attract the original and rule it. Before he was 18 years old, or at 18, he finished all the school of his day. And he studied biology, genetics. And he discovered in the germ of the black man that he could produce color. We don't call you colored. We call you black, the essence of all color. And at one time, there was no brown. All right. There was no red. All right. There was no yellow. There was just us, the original people. Now you say, well, I don't believe that. How old are the Chinese? Tell me what their calendar say. How old are the Japanese? Tell me what their calendar say. They're not but a little over 6,000 years old. The Indian, the people that you call Indians, they are not the brown man. They're not the yellow man. They are the so-called red man, but they're not red. They're original people. They predated all these other races on the earth. They and us are original people. Well, how long have we been here? Well, we don't have no calendar. You don't go among the Indians and ask them, where's your calendar giving us your birth? He said, I don't know. I've just been here. With the earth, with Mother Earth and Father Sky. I just been here.